So today I'm going to be giving you my full review on Initio, Ood for Greatness. So this one caught quite a bit of hype when it first came out, and I was a bit late to that hype train. It came out in 2018, so almost 4 years ago at this point, and just recently did I actually end up getting a bottle of this one. Twisted Lily did send this out to me for a review, so big shout out to them as always for supporting the channel and working with us here. So if you want to grab one of these for yourself and also get a discount, shop with them and use my code CHAOS10, and that'll get you 10% off of this. That'll also get you 10% off everything else on their website. It's always active and it works on everything. They have sample sets available and some other things like that, and that code can work on that stuff as well. When it comes to fragrances like this and some other niche products, you can't normally find them all at discounters or at a discount in general, but if you shop with Twisted Lily and you use that code, that's kind of a little hack where you can get some of this stuff on a discount. Also, we have to take a second and look at the bottle. Absolutely incredible. I mean, look at that. So cool. Nice matte black bottle, has a little bit of a shine to it. Of course, you have the gold accenting. I don't know how well this is picking up here, but I mean, it's incredible. You almost have to see it in person to really take it all in. The presentation is absolutely crazy. The bottle has a really nice amount of heft to it. This is a 90 ml bottle. The box and everything else involved is also really nice. It has a sleeve. I guess I could show you some of it here. The fragrance comes in this pedestal. So when you pull it out of the box, it comes like that. Then you have a card or an envelope of some sort on the back with some sort of probably brand or fragrance information in it. I haven't actually opened that up yet, but you get the idea here. When you pay this type of money, this is typically one of the benefits that you get from that. And so for people who are into good presentations, you will get that here with this one. For me, I've had so many niche fragrances from other different brands that it really doesn't do a whole lot for me anymore. But if this was like your first niche fragrance or just your first really high-end scent and you get a presentation like this, you're going to be over the moon and you're going to be hooked. So let's start off with how this smells. Now, when you first spray this one on, you'll notice maybe a similarity to another hyped niche fragrance out there, Baccarat Rouge 540. I don't know why I pointed over here, because Baccarat Rouge 540 is not over here. It is down there off camera, but that fragrance is saffron heavy, a lot of amber wood. It's very woody and transparent. And you do get a similar thing going here with this one, but the main difference is that this Initio has some oud, which you would expect, but it also has just some more depth overall. Again, Baccarat Rouge 540 is very transparent and airy and wispy. It's a beast mode, super strong scent. The scent composition, though, is on the lighter side compared to this one, where you have some heavier notes, you have some more substance, and there's just a bit more going on, I suppose. I'm gonna go ahead and read off the note breakdown here. Up top, we have saffron, nutmeg, lavender. In the mid, we have oud. In the base, patchouli and musk. Really nice note breakdown. So when you first spray it on, the saffron comes through, like I mentioned. Also the nutmeg, that's giving it a warm, spicy opening up top. Also, following that pretty quickly is the oud, and it smells incredible. Now, it is a niche scent, and it is a niche level oud for sure. Great quality here from this. However, the oud is not super unwearable. It's not like a super pure, ultra strong oud that's gonna be super piercing and that you're not gonna like. A brand new person into fragrances may not care for it that much, but if you have a good amount of experience and you've dabbled with some other niche products and you're up for a little bit of a challenge, this one will bring the heat for you, but again, it's not too crazy. For me, I really love the opening. The nutmeg comes through, it's the star of the show with that saffron. Warm, spicy, sexy, inviting. This one is one that will have you hooked right off the bat, right from the first spray. I've mentioned this before, but that's one of the things that I look for in a scent. And that's one of the things that really capture me and captivate me and you know, make me want to go back for more, is the opening. If it opens up like this, super strong, opens up with a bang, gets your attention, I know that I'm probably gonna be in for a good ride and I'm gonna love the rest of the scent into the dry down. There are some fragrances out there that open up kind of dull, kind of flat, kind of boring, and niche fragrances as well. Some open up just not with a whole lot going on, and then you're not as excited to smell the rest of it. Some may even scrub it off if the opening isn't up to their standards. So a good opening is pretty important, especially for me. And you get that here. It smells amazing off the top. And again, I don't think the oud is going to scare too many of you away. You get a nice blend of a little bit of a patchouli in here as well, along with the other notes that I mentioned. So it's not too strong. You pick up on a bit of musk in the dry down. The patchouli's still there. The oud is still there. The saffron is still there. A little bit of a clean lavender as well. As I mentioned, there's a whole lot of balance going on here, and that really makes it very wearable and very obtainable in terms of a lot of other people enjoying how it smells. So let's go ahead and touch on performance here. this is a very strong scent. This one's an eau de parfum, so it's got a decent concentration behind it. It's not even like an extrait or a pure parfum or anything, and it is an absolute monster. You don't have to worry about performance with this one. That's really all you need to hear. You just don't. You don't need to even think about it. And the reason why is because it is a 12 plus hour longevity fragrance on my skin consistently every time I wear it. Projection is also incredibly strong. Not only will this leave a nice scent trail when you walk through and it'll linger behind you, but it'll also have a good amount of distance, a good amount of projection to where when you walk into a room, it's immediately going to start dispersing out and you're going to get noticed. You do not need to go heavy on the sprays with this one. A couple sprays is plenty. If you're someone who really wants to play it safe, you would probably be able to get away with one spray. I mean, this stuff is crazy. And most of the time, that's what you would expect and that's what you would get from a niche product. Again, when you're paying this type of money, that's what you would want, and it definitely delivers on the performance side here. And that's what I was saying earlier. You don't even need to worry about it or think about it. I mean, you don't need anything stronger than this. Some people may want it to be weaker than what it is because it might be a little bit too strong for them. So, yeah. That's something where you should take into consideration. You performance junkies out there, you're gonna have a heyday with this one if you haven't tried it already. One thing I do wanna say though to that point is be careful because this may cause olfactory fatigue depending on you, your nose, that sort of thing. Fragrances like this sometimes will cause olfactory fatigue for me. Baccarat Rouge 540 is the same way. It has something to do with that saffron, I believe. So basically that means you may spray it on and it may seem weak to you. It may seem like it's not projecting. It may even get to the point where your nose tunes it out and you can barely pick up on it anymore. And then you're gonna be thinking that it's gone after a couple hours. I would bet money on the fact that it is not gone. Your nose is just blind to it. People immediately close to you, their nose could go blind to it as well. But if you walked into a brand new, fresh room where no one has smelled it, I guarantee people are going to be turning their heads and they're going to be like, holy crap, where did that just come from? So keep that in mind. This is going to be a great fall and wintertime fragrance for me for this year. Again, this is my first bottle. I have smelled this before via sample a while back. I think I've smelled it a few different times actually. So I am familiar with the scent before getting this bottle, but I never actually had a bottle to where I could put it into my rotation heavily. And I wish I would have had this a bit sooner because this would have made it in my top 10 fall niche fragrances list. Unfortunately, I didn't have it at that time of making that video. But from this point forward, now that I have it, I'm gonna be wearing it a lot as it's cooling off here. Fall, winter time, that's when this one is gonna be best for. If you guys are looking for a unique, super strong, warm, spicy, sexy, cooler weather scent and you have a bit more money to throw around, strongly consider putting it into this one. It's incredible. Again, you can't normally get it discounted all that often, so make sure you take advantage of the Chaos 10 code at Twisted Lily and grab it through them. Sometimes it goes out of stock with them as well. It's a pretty hot scent, and so I would jump on it if you want to grab it for the cooler months here, because as it gets colder, people are going to be wanting to grab this one more. That's why I'm trying to get this review out now so you can jump on it. And I also want to say it's a really good compliment getter, believe it or not. An oud fragrance, I know. It may not seem like it, but it is. A lot of it's that nutmeg, lavender, warm spiciness that this one gives off. It makes it cozy. It makes it inviting. It really does have a sexy edge to it. Kind of has a nighttime, evening out, dinner, date type of smell. It's pretty strong to wear on a date. You can do it, but just kind of an evening vibe is what this one gives off. Baccarat Rouge 540 is also a really good compliment getter. Part of it is just this DNA that they kind of share a little bit that just works like magic, works like crazy. The performance is going to get you noticed, and if you can back it up by being confident, looking great, and you know, just putting all of your effort into your appearance as well, you're going to be killing it. So guys, I think that's going to do it for me. That's my thoughts on Oud for Greatness by Initio. So glad to finally have a bottle. I've wanted one for so long. It just looks great. It smells even better, and I'm pumped for it. Can't wait to start wearing this one more as it's been cooling off here lately. Let me know down below. Have you tried Oud for Greatness? What do you think of it? Do you like it? Do you not like it? And if you don't have a bottle of this one or you haven't tried it, let me know down below. Are you going to grab a sample? Are you going to grab a bottle? Let me know what you're thinking. Again, big thank you to Twisted Lily for getting this one out to me for review. Great website. If you want any sort of niche product that you can think of, they're probably going to have it, especially with that code. You can save yourself a lot of money. And also, if you want to gain access to these videos in advance, if you want bonus videos, and if you want to join a private chat room with me and some of the other members, check out the channel memberships. It will be linked down below. You can also hit the join button next to the subscribe button. And that subscribe button should be pushed as well. That's going to do it for me. Thank you so much for watching. Stay safe, stay healthy. Have a great fall kickoff here. Let's have some fun. We'll see you tomorrow with another one. Take care.